members to this meeting here today. We're here to make, obviously, a decision on the Wirral Golf and Leisure Report. The project is one that's been around, as we know, for a very, very long time. And judging from the people here today, obviously it's something that is very important, to say the least. So with that said, I think we should get straight into the agenda and the business of the meeting today. Okay, but at the first item on the agenda is members' code of conduct. Has anyone got any declarations of interest on the table? No? Okay, thank you. Okay. Okay, item two. To be clear on the decision before us, this is not a planning committee, it's not a decision on whether to allow the scheme to go ahead. That will be a different decision, obviously, at a different time. The decision before us today is simple. We've been asked to consider investing in this scheme, and we must decide to agree to that investment or not. Before I open up to the floor, to cabinet members to speak, I want to first place on record my thanks to the members of the Scrutiny Committee, who spent much time diligently reviewing the details of this scheme and put a recommendation before us, which is in your pack. Their work, of course, is very much appreciated. I know they worked tremendously hard before they came to a decision. You've all had time to review the details of the exempt reports, and you've all had time to consider the recommendations of that same scrutiny committee. This is an opportunity for anyone who around here who disagrees with that scrutiny recommendation or wishes to debate the information on the exempt papers to please state now. Is there anybody that disagrees with that scrutiny recommendation? Wishes to debate the information on the exempt papers, please. Let me know. Janette.
Thanks, Pat. Okay, so we have all examined the papers really carefully. We've had a chance to read that since we've been released. The benefits of this scheme clear, which the obviously is to support the local high streets. And it's also clear that a lot of hard work is still to be done on assessing the environmental impact to make sure that every concern which is being raised.
Can I just stop you there just for a minute? Sorry, my apology. What I meant to say was that nobody disagreed with that scrutiny committee decision. We don't have to go into an exempt session. Okay? That's correct. Okay. Sorry, something changed.
I'll just finish what I said.
Sorry.
So I've just outlined the benefits. Great benefits as this would bring to Wirral. But what's also become clear to me is this is a huge investment for the council, and I'm not sure it's the right one at this time. We're making a massive commitment here with the funding. We have other priorities as new leadership. We need to protect the vulnerable, build on our community wealth, ensure a better range of social housing, and I think they're higher up on our agenda. I believe that this investment is possibly not in keeping with our priorities as a new administration.
Thanks, Pat. This project's from a different time. While I agree with colleagues about the potential for jobs and economic growth, I don't feel this particular scheme is something the council should be putting its own money into. We've got the Wirral Growth Company. We want to see more social housing built. We want to keep investing in children's services. I think that these are our priorities. They're all going to require major financial investment and resources. Unfortunately, I don't believe we have the capacity to invest in schemes which could and probably should be funded by the directly by the private sector.
comments, we've read the recommendations from the Scrutiny Committee, and that's in the report pack. I'd also like to move the following motion as follows. Wirral, of course, and this is important, is open for business. We've secured more than £140 million in new investments into the borough over the past 4 years through our partnership with Muse, the Wirral Growth Company, and we're moving forward, obviously, with major developments in Birkenhead, Morton and Bromley, just to get started. The council is very determined to bring investment, jobs and prosperity to Wirral. That's why major players, obviously like Celtic Manor and Redrow, want to build here in the first place. This is a scheme that creates hundreds of jobs, of new jobs, and give the Wirral Lake a huge boost. However, it is a massive investment for the council. We are in new leadership with new priorities, and after much deliberation, we decided the money we would borrow to invest in this scheme would be better spent on securing affordable and social housing for the many residents who need it elsewhere in our borough. Therefore, we won't be investing in the Hoy Lake development. Instead, we will immediately start working on a plan to increase social housing in our borough, meeting our pledge to deliver good quality housing for everyone who needs it. And we will also move forward on developing an action plan to provide real support for our struggling high streets.